Bonjour, je m'appelle Dr. Tin et bienvenue à French 2311, chapitre 8, leçon 5. Aujourd'hui, nous allons étudier l'expression il faut. Il faut. Ça va? J'espère que vous allez très bien. Hello, my name is Dr. Tin and welcome to French 2311. Chapter 8, Lesson 5. Today we are going to study the expression il faut. Il faut, which in English can be translated as it is necessary. It is necessary. Or we have to. You have to, they have to, right? So, the expression il faut, it's an impersonal expression because the il, here the il, that's not the il, that's not refer to just one person. It can be they have to, right? We have to, you have to, or simply it is necessary. Ça va? Ok. Page 216. Page 216. L'expression impersonnelle il faut. L'expression impersonnelle il faut. The il does not refer to one person. It can be translated as we have to, they have to, you have to, I have to. So il does not represent just one person. It can be translated also literally as it is necessary to do something, or something is necessary when you use a noun after il faut. Ça va? Okay, so first of all, il faut can be followed by a verb. When it's followed by a verb, the verb should be in its infinitive form. So, verb à l'infinitif, right? So, il faut, when it's used with a verb, that verb is not conjugated. When it's an ER verb, it will stay as an ER verb. RE verb, it will stay as RE verb. IR, it will stay as an IR verb. If it's one of those irregular verbs, you don't do anything to the verbs that will follow il faut. Okay, for instance, il faut étudier. Il faut étudier. You see that étudier? ER verb is not touched, right? It is necessary to study. Or we have to study. You have to study. They have to study. It can refer to any person. Ça va? Très bien. Il faut manger. Here too, manger is not touched. Manger is in its infinitive form. Ça va? It could have been any other verb. Right? Il faut sortir. Have to go out. We have to go out. Il faut descendre à Houston. You have to go down to Houston. Il faut rendre le livre. You have to give back the book. Ça va? Très bien. So, after a verb is used after il faut, you don't do anything to that verb. The verb will stay in its infinitive form. Okay. Now, the verb form il faut. Il faut comes from the infinitive of the verb faut. Il, see the verb changes to faut because of il, the conjugation. This is the infinitive of the verb for, right? Falloir. So let's say you want to use it for in a future tense with the verb aller, right? So you have to conjugate aller with il and it becomes il va. And you know that when you're doing that, the verb that will follow will have to be in its infinitive form. It is going to be necessary, right? So, il va falloir arriver à l'heure. À l'heure means on time. It's going to be necessary. It is going to be necessary to arrive on time. We have to arrive on time, right? We are going to have to arrive on time. Okay? Future tense. Il va falloir arriver à l'heure. Il va falloir. Falloir is the infinitive of faut. 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 So, il va falloir. It is going to be necessary to arrive on time. We are going to have to arrive on time. Ça va? Okay, when you are using it, the verb falloir, the expression il faut in a past tense, right? Then falloir here, right, changes into its past participle form, which is fallu, right? And it uses avoir to be in the past tense. So it was necessary. Right? It was necessary will be il a fallu. And then it can be followed by a verb. Right? So, il a fallu réserver en avance. It was necessary to reserve in advance. En avance, in advance. Let's say you're going on vacation and there's a lot of booking going on in the hotels. Where you're going to vacation, right? So you have to reserve in advance. So you had done the reservation in advance. It was necessary to reserve in advance. Il a fallu réserver en avance. It was necessary to reserve in advance because there were a lot of people going to stay at the same hotel. Ça va? So, il a fallu as the past tense. Il va falloir, the future tense, right? Now, when il faut is used in its negative form, ne, and then pas was sandwiched faut, right? So, il ne faut pas, right, will be placed with faut in between, right? The same thing you do with any other verb. So, il ne faut pas, and then followed by your verb, right? Il ne faut pas boire trop de bière. Il ne faut pas boire trop de bière. It is not necessary to drink a lot of beer. We don't have to drink a lot of beer, right? You don't have to drink a lot of beer. She doesn't have to drink a lot of beer. Ça va? Très bien. Now, il faut can also be followed by un nom, a noun, right? Il faut des vacances. I need some vacation, right? Très bien, some vacation some vacation is necessary. Il faut des vacances. Alright, I need some vacation. Some vacation is necessary. Okay, here the noun can be a noun with the definite article, with the indefinite article, or the participle article. Right? It can be a noun with the definite article or the indefinite article, or a noun with the particip article. Right? They are nouns. Ça va? Très bien. So you can say, il faut un filet de bœuf. Filet, un filet, right? The indefinite article right there, all right? Here, des oignons, the particip article in front of onions, okay? And here too, we have the particip article, de l'agneau, some lamb meat. And then here too, we have the particip article, some pepper, right? Très bien. So, il faut un filet de bœuf, deux oignons, de l'agneau et du poivre. Et du poivre pour faire la soupe. Right? We need a beef filet, right? Some onions, some lamb meat and some pepper, right? To make the soup. Il faut un filet de bœuf, des oignons, de l'agneau et du poivre pour faire la soupe. Or it can just be one simple noun. Il faut un visa pour aller en France. Il faut un visa pour aller en France. Do you need a visa to go to France? Okay. Is a visa necessary to go to France? Ça va? Au revoir et à bientôt. Au revoir et à bientôt.